All right, I picked up this McIntosh VU meter. It's called MPM4000 power output meter. Now, as you can see, this is a very small unit. This is actually meant for car stereo. It's supposed to be paired up with a tape player or a CD player in the car, which is pretty cool. I didn't know McIntosh made VU meters for cars, but anyway, I picked this up for an experiment. As some of you may be aware, I have the vintage McIntosh MI75 tube amplifiers. Those are the industrial version of the MC75 monoblocks. And since they're industrial versions of the MC75, my MI75s can be rack mounted. And I was thinking of a project to rack mount my amplifiers. And I was thinking it'd be pretty cool to maybe add VU meters to that. To bring some of the modern and vintage together, and just as a thought, as an experiment. So I went around looking for a standalone VU meter unit, kind of like this one, that I could use. And turns out McIntosh doesn't make one for just regular stereo amps. I even called McIntosh, and the response I got was they don't make anything like that. All of their VU meters are specific to the preamplifier or the amplifier. So right away they were asking me for the model of my amplifier or preamplifier. And when I said it's a vintage tube amplifier, the answer was they don't make anything like that that could just plug and play into any tube amplifier. So you can't have VU meters with MC275 or any of the vintage tube amplifiers. And they told me that the VU meter is specific to the circuitry and the wattage of the amp, which totally makes sense. So if you have a 100-watt amp, then this meter here needs to reflect that and be 100-watt max. And 200 and 300 and vice versa, it needs to reflect that. And that totally makes sense. But I was thinking, hey, if there's a 100-watt one, I could hook it up to my 75-watt amplifier, and I would know that it would never reflect the proper 75 watts. But anyway, it would work for me. But turns out it's not just a simple plug and play. They have a proprietary circuit built in to the VU meter design that's looking for a particular amplifier or preamplifier to plug into. So I could not do that. So while researching, I just came across this particular unit, which looks like an independent unit. And I thought, I wonder if the stereo VU amp would work with my amps. So I pulled up the manual for this before buying it. And in the manual, I saw that maybe it can work. So here's the manual, and it says here that this thing can be paired up operates at 4 ohms. As you can see here, it says the meter scale, both wattage and decibels are accurately calibrated when there is a 4 ohm impedance loudspeaker. So this tells me that this unit should be able to plug into the 4 ohm tap on the amplifier, and it should work in theory. And then I saw this. This looks a little complicated because there is just a lot of wires here, because obviously it's meant for car stereo. So I don't know about this part. It will require some trial and error, and I'll try to figure it out. Now, the important part I see here is the one on the bottom. It looks like, just like speaker terminals, it's got the left channel and the right channel, positive and negative. So this is the part, these are the wires that can hook up to the back of the amplifier at the end. The 4 ohms is what we're looking for. So this gives me hope that it should work. And it's a standalone unit, meaning it worked with, I believe, multiple other a McIntosh car stereo unit. So this gives me hope. And I know, first of all, this will require 12 volts. So that part is okay. I could find I have 12 volt adapters. and wall warts I can use to hook this up to, except I just don't know how these wires would connect. I'm thinking these would not connect to the amplifier, only the speaker wires would. The rest would be need to be managed somehow with just power. There is a ground lead to vehicle chassis. Maybe I can hook this up to the amp chassis. That should work. And then there is backup lead to battery. This should be power, maybe hot. Vehicle dash illumination. Amp remote turn on from control center. So these are for your car ignition when you put the key in and turn it on, what comes up, what illuminates before you even start the car, or whether the unit's on or not. That's what determines that sequence in a car, but we don't have that. So I'll have to figure out how this works, but I'll give it a shot. And as far as the 4-ohm connection goes to the speakers, white and white, black, gray, and gray, black wires are for the left and right channel. So here we have the gray and the gray. So these would be one channel. So the gray wires are, this is a channel here, gray and gray, black. And he's got it's got the car stereo connectors. That shouldn't matter. We'll figure something out. I gotta jerry-rig this thing to work with an amplifier. Let's see if it does. And then there is the white and the white. So these four, sorry, I'm trying to do this one-handed. These four here should be the two channels, positive and negative. Hook it up to the amp. Now, the one thing I would want to know is this thing is saying 4 ohms. Is it drawing 4 ohms? That's very important because you don't want to overload the amp. For example, is the amp going to read this thing as a speaker, or is it fairly low draw where the amp doesn't care or know that it's even hooked up? To find that out, I can use a multimeter to figure out how many ohms is this the draw will be. Let me pull my multimeter out and I'll probably show you. Let's find out what's going on there. All right, the multimeter is on. It's set to ohms. I've already hooked up the positive lead. Now I'm going to hook up the negative here and we should see the reading. Okay, so that's high. That is 46,000 ohms, which is good, which is really good. So if you see up here, it says K, that's not 4 ohms, that's 46,000 ohms, almost close to 47. And that's really good because that means it's barely gonna draw anything from the amplifier. So the higher the ohms, the lower the draw. So when we have speakers that are 4 ohms compared to 8 ohms, the 8 ohms draw less from the amplifier compared to the 4 ohms. That's why when you look at the amp ratings, you will see that it will say 100 watts at 4 ohms and something like 200 watts at 8 ohms. So the fact that this is 46, close to 47,000 ohms means it's going to be a negligible draw from the amp, where the amp won't even know that this thing is connected, which means we should be able to plug it in and hook it up to the speaker terminals, these cables here, right next to the speaker terminal, meaning we could double tap, connect the speaker as well as this unit, these wires, and it should get the reading for the needle here for the VU meter, and it won't draw more than what the speaker is drawing. So that's a really good thing. I'm glad that this is not actually 4 ohms. So also this theory, this design also is implemented on some of the active subwoofers where you can double tap and hook it up to the speaker terminals along with the actual speaker cables, and the subwoofer itself is barely drawing anything from the amplifier, so it's convenient that way. So that's good. So this looks promising. I'm fairly certain at this point that this could work, but I'm really not sure. We'll see what happens. not sure about all these wires and how they need to be connected. If it works, it'd be a great little experiment. Yeah, I don't know if I could actually use this as a VU meter for my monoblocks. They're very small. I wish the meters were a little bigger, but of course this is for radio, so I'm asking for too much. You know, McIntosh actually sells a box with the McIntosh logo for like $1,500. I think it's really a missed opportunity for McIntosh. If they actually created a decent size standalone VU meter, I think there is some market for that for some of the vintage amps, or any amp really that does not have a VU meter. But they probably don't do that because they don't want anybody to be using a McIntosh meter with any amp. Because technically, if this works, this can work with any amp. I should be able to hook this up to my Marantz 8B or even a solid state amp, and it would work. And maybe that's what they don't want. So, we'll see. We'll see how it goes. All right, so I've decided to pair this unit with this Eico amp. This is an Eico HF-81. It's an integrated tube amp that uses EL84 tubes. It's fairly compact and easy to use, so I've decided to use this to experiment with this VU meter. And the idea is, if this works, if this is successful, if this unit is able to work, the meter works and the needle is able to move and respond to the sound coming from the Eico, that would essentially mean that this unit can be paired up with any amp, should be able to connect it to the speaker out on any of the amplifiers, and that'd be great as an experiment. If it works, I'll try it next with my 8B and then eventually with the Macintosh MI75s. All right, so I was able to hook it up to a 12 volt power source, so it lit up, it looks great, and I've plugged everything in, I think, properly, but I'm not getting the VU meter needles to move. So I have to figure that out. And also, I notice the Macintosh logo, I don't know why that's blue, that's supposed to be green. Don't know if it's not working right or what, but I still have to figure that out. But yeah. All right, so the good news is the Macintosh logo lit up green, and that's wonderful. The bad news is the meters themselves, the light is gone. The amp is playing, but needle's not moving, and the blue lights are gone. So, yeah, one step forward, two step backwards. I'm hoping I didn't destroy anything in the process, but I'm gonna try one more combination of wires and plug them in different configuration and see if that works. Right.
3 hours later.
All right, so I finally figured it out after tinkering around and trying different things. Everything lights up. I think it works now. So let me put something on for you so you can see how it works. So it's Eico with the Mac VU meters. I think it's a success. Is this practical or viable? Probably not. But is it fun? Yes, it was fun. I would file this under fun projects.